Frontline medical contacts between China and Africa. In Algeria, when Chinese doctors first entered isolation wards at a major hospital for COVID-19, they were greeted warmly by local patients.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Do you have a cough?
هل كلك أكيد تسألني ولا لا؟
أنا
مسألني. Yes. شوية. Yes.
Do you have a
The facilities are good. The wards are equipped with necessary devices for COVID-19 patients. The staffing is sufficient, and they're taking good care of the patients.
It is a great pleasure for us to share our experiences. China is a step ahead, witnessing the early cases of COVID-19. So its experience allows us to understand and predict the future state of our patients.
And in Sudan, which has reported the highest number of COVID-19 cases in Eastern Africa, Chinese experts have entered the ICU.
For now, we have six patients already.
Six patients, okay.
So this is patient right now, he's already ventilated.
Oh, okay.
He's been here for around 4 days already. They already intubated.
Ready incubation.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's very severe.
This is the newest and largest hospital in Sudan. It started operations since May, and it has a capacity of 480 beds. And now this hospital is designated for receiving the COVID-19 patients. Currently, there are a total of over 70 patients living in this hospital, living in the wards right behind me.
Most of those patients in this hospital have mild or moderate symptoms. The Chinese team visited 7 hospitals in Sudan, providing suggestions on treatment.
We showed them our capacity of the isolation centers, and we showed them our little experience during these last 3 months. And we'll also do more presentations and video conference with your experts there in China.
After our visit, we'd like to take 1 or 2 samples for an in-depth case study. We will also discuss the cases remotely with other experts in China if necessary.
So far, China has sent over 20 medical teams overseas to help combat the coronavirus, 7 of them to African countries.